Welcome to Silo Cinema, Real Time's online experimental short film screening.
Silo Cinema offers the opportunity for anyone to share their work. For many of the groups that Real Time works with, it provides a unique opportunity for them to get their work seen.
Empty windows, empty halls. No knocking made upon these doors. Parks and benches left to rot. But up in the sky, the tiny dots. Flames will flicker in the dark. The stars at night stay strong and stark. So when alone, look up and stare at the oldest painting that will always be there.
Are you sure this is the place?
I'm sure. We've got to go in, get the case, out. Simple.
Okay then.
Open the door.
I'm trying.
Hurry up.
Right, grab the case and nothing else.
Okay.
Leave that room alone, we're only here for the case.
Alright. Well, it's gone.
It's all gone.
The briefcase.
Dad.
And the ruby.
Dad, get out there. Get out there. Go.
They're done out here. They're done.
I can't believe how long we've been walking for.
I can't believe you took that ruby after me telling you not to. You never listen to anything I say. Are you even listening now?
Oh, I think we're being followed. Let's go this way.
Where the f*** did they go?
Hey Sam, do you think parallel timelines exist?
In a parallel timeline where everything is sold through ritual combat.
I think burgers have got to be the best food.
Nah, hot dogs are better.
In a parallel timeline where everyone is extremely aggressive.
Do you think the moon is a liberal myth?
Yes, obviously.
Nah, it couldn't be, that's crazy.
Are you calling the Eliza?
In a parallel timeline when everyone is an undercover cop.
Do you know I can buy some drugs?
Yes. Follow me.
You're under arrest,
wait a minute.
In a parallel timeline where women are on fire.
Calm down, no, calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Yes, she's dead.
in a parallel timeline where everything is TV reference.
Hey Sam, I think we should date.
I think we should just be friends.
In a parallel timeline where there is no light.
Hey, did you see that?
No.
Me neither.
In a parallel timeline where Sam and Liam are incredibly late. Parallel timeline where breathing is easy to forget. In a parallel timeline where everyone is Australian. In a parallel timeline where Sam is a failing magician.
And now I'll pull the rabbit out of the... Oh. Oh no.
In a parallel timeline where Sam and Liam are very depressed.
Oh wait, that's this one.
As you can see, this vehicle, this magnificent vehicle, it's just passed its MOT. It's just been washed. It's gleaming. I mean, it's just magnificent. It's a cult. It's a cult vehicle.
Sadly, men tend to snuff it before women, and the coronavirus has only made this situation worse. This means that there are a lot of spare widows around. These widows could be usefully recycled, but some of them are in a bit of a scruffy state. That's where our professional widow cleaning service comes in. Special rates available for care homes.
This vehicle now, I mean, it's magnificent. Look at it, it's mint. It's mint, isn't it? You could go anywhere in this, you could take anyone anywhere in this. In this vehicle.
Modern life is busy. We should learn to be more mindful and to treasure the precious moments before they're gone forever. When did you last sob comfortingly into the warm, soft fur of a toy monkey? When did you last walk into a newsagent and carefully select an item of real paper magazine pornography from the top shelf? This man says that this woman isn't a bully. This man says that this woman isn't a bully. Cut! This isn't working, is it? Do you want to have another stab? Yeah, you can have two stabs if you like. Sounds like a plan.
I mean, take Princess Diana. Well, we should say, I suppose, the late Princess Diana. Yeah, you could pop her in the back. Pop Princess Diana in the back, and you know she wouldn't look out of place. It's magnificent.
If you've been affected by any of the issues raised in this film, get down to the newsagent and buy some real hardcore.
was a beautiful warm summer's day. The garden was alive with the sounds of birds singing in the trees. Kieran, a 5-year-old deaf boy, lay in the grass, watching the trees sway in the gentle breeze and the clouds race across the sky. As he lay there, he tuned into his cochlear implant and practiced listening to all the sounds around him. There was suddenly a new sound, something very different to what he expected in the garden. He could see a strange pattern in the sky and feel the air whooshing around him. Slowly, a disc-shaped metal object came and hovered over the bottom of the garden. Kieran got up and quickly walked down the garden for a closer look. He was mesmerized by the shiny metal disc spinning and hovering over the lawn. He wasn't at all afraid, but wondered what it could be. As he watched, a circular-shaped hole appeared on the underside of the disc, and a small, very strange little creature descended, standing on a saucer-shaped platform. The creature seemed familiar, but Kieran knew he had never met him before. As he thought about it, it came to him. It was a beautiful warm summer's day. The garden was alive with the sounds of birds singing in the trees. Kieran, a 5-year-old deaf boy, lay in the grass, watching the trees sway in the gentle breeze and the clouds race across the sky. As he lay there, he tuned into his cochlear implant and practiced listening to all the sounds around him. There was suddenly a new sound. Something very different to what he expected in the garden. He could see a strange pattern in the sky and feel the air whooshing around him. Slowly, a disc-shaped metal object came and hovered over the bottom of the garden. Kieran got up and quickly walked down the garden for a closer look. He was mesmerized by the shiny metal disc spinning and hovering over the lawn. He wasn't at all afraid, but wondered what it could be. As he watched, a circular-shaped hole appeared on the underside of the disc, and a small, very strange little creature descended, standing on a saucer-shaped platform. The creature seemed familiar, but Kieran knew he had never met him before. As he thought about it, it came to him. There was a creature just like him in his Toy Story movie. The creature started to wave, and Kieran saw that he was signing. Somehow, he knew sign language. "My name is Alien," he signed. "What's your name?" "My name is Kieran," the little boy signed back enthusiastically. Alien beckoned to Kieran to come towards him. As they met, they greeted each other with a high five. Alien invited Kieran for a ride on his spaceship. Kieran was so excited. It was the beginning of many adventures they would have together.
Autumn is one of my favourite time of the years. I love going into woods to have a look at the changing colours of the trees and the leaves. And it gives me an enormous sense of positivity and freedom. As there's so much to take in, I like to find a place in the woods, put my camera on, and let it record for some time. I'll then come back, put the camera away, walk to another area of the woods, set it up, and let it record again. I'll pick it all up, take it home, and we'll have a look to see what I've got. What is that? Thank you.
hope you've enjoyed Silo Cinema. If you've got a film you'd like to show or an idea for a future theme for Silo Cinema, then please get in touch with us. We'd love to hear from you.